Okay, now this was the question that we were doing yesterday's class. Now anybody who is still having doubt in the pair formation, anyone who is still not clear with the pair formation, how the pairs are formed, just reply if anyone is having any doubt in the pair formation. If you are not clear with the pair formation, I'll explain it again. These are the indexing. The mean terms are first segregated by the index numbering based on the binary designation of the mean terms present in the function. Now, accordingly, the index numbering, we have the different mean terms present in the different index group. Now, after indexing, we are moving to the second column for pair formation. Now, what do we do for pair formation? For the pair formation, we compare the terms of index one group to index two group. Clear? Now we check for the binary designation, that the binary designation of the two terms of index one and index two should have only 1 bit difference. So if they are having only 1 bit difference, it can form a pair. And we'll mention here the bit differing position in the bracket. So that is how we are forming pairs. Is everybody clear with this concept? How the pairs are formed? Is everyone clear? If it is clear, I'll proceed further. Or you want me to explain, because this has been explained twice in the class. दो बार explain हो चुका है in the yesterday's class and day before yesterday's class. It's clear, right? The pair formation and how the groups has been divided. This is the first group which is having 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7 pairs. The seven pairs are formed by comparing the terms of index one and index two. Clear? So we'll compare the individual terms. एक-एक terms को compare करना start करेंगे. Like we'll compare the one with three, one with five, one with six, one with nine, and one with 12. And accordingly, we'll compare two also with all the five mean terms. And then we'll compare eight with all the five mean terms. And we'll check for the binary designations, whether there is only 1 bit difference or not. If there is only 1 bit difference, it will be converted to a pair. And the bracket position shows the bit differing position. Clear? So this is the first group, that is by comparing index one and index two terms. Similarly, the second group is of by comparing index two and index three. Index two or three को compare करेंगे, we'll be getting these many pairs. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So these are the six pair that will be obtained just by comparing the index two and index three. Clear? Just a second. So the index two and index three will compare and we'll get six pairs. Then after that, we'll compare index three and index four. Clear? So index three and index four will be compared, and again we'll be getting two pairs. So here, by the comparing the mean terms of the different index groups, we'll be getting the pairs. Now after this, we'll move to the third column. That is, we'll check by the dash positions from the first group to the second group. Clear? Now, if we are getting the same dash position, then we'll check with the rest of the 3 bits. Rest of the 3 bits, if 1 bit is differing, then it will be the two pairs will be converted to quad. Clear? So that is how the quad conversion is taking place. Clear? Now, here we have got five quads, as we can see P, Q, R, S, and T. These are the five quads. Now, with these five quads, we have also mentioned the differing position, where the dash lies. The dash lies in these positions, that is 2, 4, 4, 8, 4, 8, 1, 4, 1, 4, and 2, 8. Can anybody write the binary designation of 1, 3, 5, 7 quad? 1, 3, 5, 7 quad ka binary designation kya ho? Kya hoga? Yes, with the differing position mentioned in the bracket. Here we'll write A B C D. A B C and D. Clear? A B C D is written. Now the dashed positions are 2 and 4. 2 is the position C. How can we find the 2 is position C? Yes, how can we find that 2 is the position C? Anyone, just turn on your audio and reply if you know the answer. Yes, reply first. 2, 4 mein dash hai, then what would be the binary designation of the quad 1, 3, 5, 7? This is what I want to know. If we are not writing, yahan par humne binary designations nahi likha hai, then also we can write the binary designation here. I explained it in yesterday's class. Anyone who is not, yes, 2 to the power 1, correct. Here D is 2 to the power 0, C is 2 to the power 1, B is 2 to the power 2, and A is 2 to the power 3. So this is how we'll have the different power positions. So A, B, C, D, depending on these positions, will have the dash. Now here it is saying 2 and 4. 2 and 4, that means 2 to the power 1 will have dash. Then 2 to the power 4, that is B position, will have dash. Now, what is the mean term present in the quad? Mean term, that is the minimum value of the mean term present in the quad. What is it? 1, 3, 5, 7 is the minimum value of the mean term present in the quad. What is it? Yes, reply. Minimum value of the mean term. Kaun sa hai yahan pe? It's definitely 1, right? 1 is the minimum value of the mean term present in the quad. And what is the binary designation of 1? Binary designation of 1 is 0001. Correct. So A will be 0 and these two are dash, D is 1. That's it. So we'll just write the minimum value of the mean term present in the quad. The dash position will be mentioned first. Sabse pehle hum dash position ko wahan pe mention karenge while writing the binary designation. After that, we'll fill the rest of the position by the binary designation of the minimum value of the mean term present in the quad. Now, can anybody tell what would be the binary designation of S, that is the quad 1, 5, 9, 13? 1, 5, 9, 13. What would be the binary designation of S? Yes, I want an answer, fatafat. 1, 5, 9, 13, the dash position is at 4 and 8. 4 and 8, Atul, is dash, is it double dash or single dash, Atul? It will be double dash, right? Dash, dash, then 1. It 1 is the minimum mean term. So dash, dash, 0, 1. Correct. So here it will be dash, then 1 more dash. Here it is 0. And then 1. Correct. Dash, dash, 0, 1. What about R? What would be the binary designation of R? Yes. Dash position is 1 and 4. 1 and 4 ka kya hai? Yes. 0, dash, 1 dash. Correct. Here 1 and 4 are dash position. So 1 is position D, 4 is position B. So here we'll put, mark a dash. Then the minimum mean term is 2. And what is its binary designation? 2 is 0010. So here we'll mark a 0 dash 1 dash. Clear? 0 dash 1 dash. Now we'll come to Q. What is it? Q is 8, 9, 12, 13. Then the dash position is 1, 4. Correct. It's again 1 and 4. And the minimum mean term is 8. So it will be 1. 8 is what? 1, 0, 0, 0. Now dash position will leave as it is. Then it will be 0. So 1 dash, 0 dash. Now then we'll write the binary for P. P ka kya hoga? 5, 7, 13, 15. Dash position is 2, 8. Dash position is 2, 8. So 8 and then 2. This one. Then the minimum midterm is 5. What is it? It's 0, 1, 0, 1. So it is 1 and 1. Clear? So this is going to be our P. Okay? So is it clear till here, everyone, students? Yahan tak clear hai sabko? How do we write the binary designation out of this? Iska binary designation kaise likhna hai? Is this clear? Clear, right? Now we'll move on to write the terms of it. Now here, as we have seen, the binary designation of P is dash 1 dash 1. So here it is written dash 1 dash 1. Dash 1 dash 1 matlab, this is a dash which is mentioned by X. Now 1 is written as it is. Now this is again a dash which is mentioned by X. X means that doesn't matter whether it is 0 or 1. But these values has to be 1. So what is it? This is the B and this one is D. Since this one is A, B, C and D. These are the four variables. So A is dash, B is 1, C is dash, D is 1. So the term will be just BD. Clear? So this is how we write the term out of it. Now we'll move to Q. What was Q? 1 dash 0 dash. This is what it's written. 1 dash 0 dash. Yahan par humne likha tha. 1 dash 0 dash. 1 dash, that means it will be cross. 0 and then a cross. That is a dash position. So A is 1, C is 0. So the term will be AC bar. Clear? The term will be AC bar. Now coming to R. What is R? The binary designation is 0 dash 1 dash. 0 dash 1 dash. Clear? 0 dash 1 dash. Dash position is crossed. Ye humne cross kar diya. Now this is A is 0. C is 1. B is dash. D is dash. So it will be A bar C. Wherever it is 0, it will be bar. That is the complemented form. If it is 1, it will be taken directly. That is the only thing that we'll have to understand. Clear? So this is how the term is written. Now coming to R ke baad S, this one. What is it? S is dash dash 01. Dash dash 01. As we can see, is this written as S is this what? Dash dash 01. So dash dash position is taken as cross, cross, cross. Then 0 and 1. What is 0? 0 is C position and 1 is D position. Hence the term is C bar D. Clear? So this is how S is written. Now coming to T, the last one, this one. We go in this direction. We can even go in this direction. किसी भी direction में आप numbering कर सकते हो. The last quad formation is marked P, and then it's going in backward direction. आप किसी भी form में numbering करो, that will hardly affect. Clear? That has nothing to do with anything. कुछ भी नहीं है. आप बस numbering करोगे और उसका आप terms लिखोगे. ठीक है? The last one is T. T क्या था? 0-1. As we can see from here, यहाँ पर हमने mention किया था 0-1. So 0-1 is 0 × 1. So 0 is A bar and this is D, A bar D. Clear? So from here we have got 5 quads and we have written the terms of this 5 quads. Now there is one more step that we need to understand. Ki ek aur step kya hoga? Clear? Yahan tak clear hai? How have we written the terms of it is clear or not? Ye clear nahi hoga to hum aage proceed nahi kar payenge. This has to be very clear to each one of you. Is this clear, students? Everyone, just reply whether the term writing concept is clear or not. Yes, reply first. Students, reply first. I'm waiting for your replies. Clear, right? Okay. Now we have written the terms of the quads that we have obtained, but it's not compulsory कि सारे क्वाड जरूरी हो. आर यू गेटिंग माई पॉइंट? वट आई एम सेइंग कि हमने इसमें सारे पॉसिबल क्वाड्स बना दिए हैं. हम क्या करते हैं जब हम एक्सप्रेशन रिड्यूस करते हैं के मैप के थ्रू, वी आर फॉर्मिंग ओनली दोज क्वाड्स विच इज रिक्वायर्ड. जितनी जरूरत होती है सिर्फ उसी का क्वाड फॉर्मेशन करते हैं. वट इज इम्पॉर्टेंट टू कवर ऑल द मेन टर्म्स. क्लियर? तो यहाँ पर जो क्वाड फॉर्मेशन हो रहे हैं वो मैक्सिमम पॉसिबल क्वाड फॉर्मेशन हो रहे हैं. तो यहाँ पर हमें चेक करना है कि इफ एनी ऑफ दीज इज नॉट रिक्वायर्ड और इफ ऑल ऑफ दीज आर रिक्वायर्ड. सो वी नीड टू चेक अगेन. जस्ट अंडरस्टैंड द कंसेप्ट व्हाट आई एम ट्राइंग टू से. यहाँ पर हमने जो पेयर फॉर्मेशन किया था वो सारे पॉसिबल पेयर्स थे. यहाँ पर भी जो पेयर फॉर्मेशन किया वो सारे पॉसिबल पेयर्स है, और यहाँ पर जो हमने क्वाड फॉर्मेशन किया वो सारे पॉसिबल क्वाड्स है. सो वी नीड टू चेक इफ ऑल आर रिक्वायर्ड और नॉट. फॉर दैट वी आर फॉर्मिंग अ प्राइम इम्प्लिकेंट चार्ट. प्राइम इम्प्लिकेंट चार्ट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. नाउ फॉर दिस वी आर राइटिंग ऑल द क्वाड्स दैट वी हैव फॉर्म्ड and we are writing in the columns the number of mean terms present in it. Here we have got all the mean terms 1 2 3 5 6 7 8 9 12 13 15. So here we have written all the mean terms present in it. Now we'll just put a cross mark where the mean terms are coming in the quads. Now in P, as we have seen, P comprises of 5, 7, 13 and 15. So below this, यहाँ पर इस particular row में हमने सारे mean terms लिखे हैं. All the mean terms which are present in the function, that is 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 12, 13, 15. फिर यहाँ पर हम line से सारे quads लिखेंगे. Now we'll just mark across the mean terms which are present in this particular quad. Now P comprises of 5, 7, 13 and 15. Now Q is 8, 9, 12, 13. 8, 9, 12, 13. R is 2, 3, 6, 7. 2, 3, 6, 7. S is 1, 5, 9, 13. 1, 5, 9, 13. T is 1, 3, 5, 7. 1, 3, 5, 7. Clear? So here we'll be checking with the essential prime implicant. Now, what is an essential prime implicant? Essential prime implement, define karo. Anyone just turn on your audio and define essential prime implicant. Essential prime implicant kya hota hai? I explained it very clearly in the class. What was essential prime implicant? Yes? Anybody who remembers? No one. It should consist of a single one at least, which is not shared by any other prime implicant. Aaya yaad aaya? It should just consist of kam se kam ek one aisa hona chahiye jo koi aur share na kar raha ho. Clear? So here we need to check ye paanch jo humne quad banaye hain ye kya hai. These are nothing but prime implicants. Ye aapke prime implicants hai. Clear? Now when these are prime implicants, we need to check among the 5 prime implicants which one is an essential prime implicant. Kaun sa aisa hai jo essential hai. Now isse kya hoga ki hame wo particular prime implicant ko to rakhna hi padega. क्योंकि वो आपका एक ऐसा मीन टर्म को कवर कर रहा है जो कोई और शेयर नहीं की के है. दूसरा, हमें वो वाले क्वाड्स को और वो वाले प्राइम इम्प्लिकेंट्स को रिमूव करने पड़ेंगे जिसमें कि सारे मीन टर्म्स शेयर हो रहे हैं. सो वील हैव टू चेक फॉर एसेंशियल प्राइम इम्प्लिकेंट. याद आया कि नहीं एसेंशियल प्राइम इम्प्लिकेंट? इट इज अ प्राइम इम्प्लिकेंट इन विच एटलीस्ट अ सिंगल mean term or a single one should be there which is not shared by any other prime implicant jo koi aur share nahi kar raha hai. Clear? So we'll check with it. P consists of 5, 7, 13, 15. 5 to share ho raha hai. 5 is shared by S and T also. Then coming to 7 bhi share ho raha hai. 7 भी शेयर हो रहा है एज वी कैन सी फ्रॉम द चार्ट. कमिंग टू 13 भी शेयर हो रहा है बट 15 इज नॉट शेयर्ड बाय एनी अदर प्राइम इम्प्लिकेंट. वी कैन सी फ्रॉम द चार्ट 5 इज शेयर्ड बाय एस एंड टी. एस और टी दोनों यूज कर रहा है. 7 भी आर और टी यूज कर रहा है. 13 क्यू एंड TS यूज कर रहा. सो हियर वी आर यूजिंग 15. 15 इज नॉट शेयर्ड बाय एनी अदर प्राइम इम्प्लिकेंट. क्लियर? हेंस पी इज EPI. पी का क्लियर हो गया कि एसेंशियल प्राइम इम्प्लिकेंट है. ये हमें चाहिए ही आपके एक्सप्रेशन में. नाउ is Q an essential prime implicant? Q essential prime implicant hai kya? Yes, just tell me. Q is an essential prime implicant? Yes. How come? Kaun sa mean term hai that is not shared? Kaun sa mean term share nahi ho raha hai? 8, 9, 12, 13. 8 is also not shared. 12 is also not shared. ठीक है, 8 and 12 are not shared. तो Q भी आपका EPI है. Q भी EPI है. ठीक है? What about R? R is an essential prime implicant or not? Yes. Yes, it is. R, it is 2, 3, 6, 7. 2 is not shared by anyone. 3 is shared. 6 is not shared. So it is having two mean terms which are not shared बाय एनी अदर प्राइम इम्प्लिकेंट, तो आर भी आपका ईपीआई है, ठीक है। नाउ व्हाट अबाउट एस, एस हैज 1, 5, 9 एंड 13, तो विल चेक विथ 1, 1 इज गेटिंग शेयर, 5 इज ऑल्सो गेटिंग शेयर, 9 भी शेयर हो रहा है, 13 भी हो रहा है, तो एस इज नॉट एन एसेंशियल प्राइम इम्प्लिकेंट, एस नहीं है। व्हाट अबाउट टी, नो, अगेन टी इज ऑल्सो नॉट एन एसेंशियल प्राइम इम्प्लिकेंट, ऑल द मीन टर्म्स आर शेयर्ड बाय अदर प्राइम इम्प्लिकेंट्स ऑल्सो, क्लियर। सो वी नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड दैट ईदर एस और टी विल बी देयर इन द एक्सप्रेशन, तो हम जब 5, 7, 13, 15, सॉरी जब हम पी क्यू आर को ले रहे हैं, पी क्यू आर द एसेंशियल प्राइम इम्प्लिकेंट्स, तो ये आपके मिनिमल एक्सप्रेशन में होगा ही। सो अमंग फ्रॉम एस एंड टी विल चूज इधर एस और टी, सो कौन सा चूज करना है, कैसे चूज करना है, वी नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड। जब हम पी क्यू आर ले रहे हैं तो पी में आपका 5 कवर हो रहा है, 7 कवर हो रहा है, 13 कवर हो रहा है, 15 कवर हो रहा है। नाउ व्हेन वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट क्यू, 8, 9, 12 एंड 13, सो दीज आर ऑल कवर्ड। नाउ कमिंग टू 2, 6, 2, 3, 6, 7, आर आर इज 2, 3, 6, 7, 2, 3, 6, 7 ऑलरेडी कवर्ड, सो विच वन इज लेफ्ट, 1, 1 इज द मेन टर्म विच इज लेफ्ट, that can be either cover by S or by T, any one, कोई भी एक आप ले सकते हो, clear? So this needs to be checked कि आपके कौन कौन से mean terms essential prime implicant से cover हो रहे हैं, और जो essential नहीं है उनमें से कोई एक आप choose कर सकते हो। So we'll write the expression of PQ, P plus Q plus R plus S from here. These are the terms P, Q, R, S. P is BD, Q is AC bar, R is A bar C from here, S is C bar D. So if I am taking T, it is BD plus AC bar plus A bar C plus A bar D. So this is how we are writing the expression. Is this concept clear, students? ये concept clear है कि नहीं? Tabular method यहीं तक खत्म नहीं होता है, हमें prime implicant chart के through उसको complete करना है, and then finally we have to write the minimal expressions possible. कौन कौन से minimal expression possible है? We have got 5 quads, but all the 5 quads are not required. We need to check for essential prime implicant. जो essential prime implicant है वो तो आपका definitely रहेगा, but जो नहीं है उसमें से आपको choose करना है कि कौन सा main term आपको cover करना है जो कि बच गया है, तो accordingly we'll choose the prime implicant which is used. Clear? Now in this one, this was the question. I want to just go back to the steps. Here, indexing the mean term. This was our first step. Comparing each term in the lowest index group to each term in the succeeding group. Okay? The groups are combinable if their binary representation differ by single bit. Now, combined terms consist of original fixed peak representation and differing bit replaced by dash. ये आपको करना है. Now place a tick mark in front of the combined terms. ये मैंने बोला है, जो भी आप combined कर रहे हो उसको tick करोगे, ठीक है, and the combined term write in the next column. Repeat until all possible combinations are used. Now comparing the step 3, for quad formation will form quad, that is by dash position again. Then we'll list all the prime implicants and draw the prime implicant chart. Then obtain the EPI and write the minimal expression. You need to remember the term prime implicant and the essential prime implicant. ये दोनों टर्म को समझना बहुत जरूरी है, ठीक है? प्राइम इम्प्लिकेंट एंड द एसेंशियल प्राइम इम्प्लिकेंट. नाउ इफ द क्वेश्चन हैज डी गिवन टू इट, दैट इज डोंट केयर, तो हम डोंट केयर को भी वैसे ही यूज करेंगे. हियर एज वी हैव टेकन ऑल द इंडेक्सिंग, इंडेक्सिंग में हमने 6, 7, 8, 9 आर द mean terms given to us and D is the don't care terms. तो हम यहाँ पर दोनों use करेंगे, indexing में mean terms और don't care terms दोनों को use करेंगे और उसके बाद हम indexing करेंगे. That is for indexing we'll segregate the mean terms by their binary designation having number of ones present in it. ठीक है, सो इंडेक्स 1, इंडेक्स 2, 3, 4, एज वी हैव 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, तो 10 कम्स अंडर इंडेक्स 2, 11, 13 एंड 14 इन इंडेक्स 3, 12 अगेन इंडेक्स 2, देन 15 इंडेक्स 4. तो दिस इज हाउ वील इंक्लूड डी टर्म्स ऑल्सो वाइल इंडेक्सिंग and then forming pairs and quads. This is the example that we'll check in the class. यहाँ पर आपका pair combination हो गया. I'm not going to do it one by one again as we have already done. बहुत बार कर चुके हैं. तो आप pair formation कैसे करोगे? By checking the term of index 1 and index 2. तो यहाँ पर हमें तीन pairs मिलेंगे. 2 और 3 को check करेंगे. So here we'll get these many pairs. 3 and 4 we'll get these many pairs. And then we'll check this group with this group for quad formation. Yahan par hamara ye quad formation ho gaya. We'll check with this group for quad formation again. So we have got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 quads. Now we can check for octet formation. Octet formation ke liye, again we'll check for the same dash position. Now anyone with the same dash position, this is 1-4 and 1-4. So these are the same dash position. We'll check for the rest of the two bits. Iska kya hoga? Binary designation, 8, 9, 12, 13 ka. What would be the binary designation? 1-4 dash position hai. Kya hoga? Yes, anyone? Reply fast, students. 8, 9, 12, 13, फिर 1-4 as the differing binary position, dash position. What would be the binary designation? 8, 9, 12, 13 with 1 and 4. Yes, students, reply fast. With 1-4, there would not three dash. Three dash matlab aap quad octet mein convert kar rahe ho. I'm asking about this one. Quad ka kitna hoga? 1 and 4. If I'm having A, B, C, D. So one is this position. Here I'm having dash. This is again a dash. So this one, 8, 9, 12, 13, 1 and 4 is dash position. So what is the minimum mean term? It's 8. So it will be 1, 8 is what? 1, 0, 0, 0. So it will be 1 dash 0 dash. This is going to be our answer. 1 dash 0 dash for this one. इसका क्या होगा? इसका क्या होगा? 10, 11, 14, 15. 10, 11, 14, 15. What would be the binary designation? Yes, it will be 1 dash. It's 1 4 10 11 14 15. 11 ka kya hota hai? It's 1 0 1 sorry 10 ka. 10 is the minimum min term. It's 1 0 1 0. So 1 dash 1 dash. Clear? So it will be 1 dash 1 dash. So we have to compare these two. So in these two, as we have seen, that these are the dash position and only one bit is varying. So it will be 1 dash dash and dash, 3 dash. Clear? So that will be converted to an octet. Ye convert ho gaya. 8, 9, this is this one. 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. ये पूरे आपके मेन टर्म्स ऑक्टेट में कन्वर्ट हो गए. क्लियर? तो यहाँ पर हम इसको भी चेक कर सकते हैं. 1 2 एंड 1 2 सिंस दे आर द सेम सेट ऑफ मेन टर्म्स, तो ये भी आपका कन्वर्ट हो जाएगा. क्लियर? तो ये हो गया, इसको टिक कर दिया, इसको टिक कर दिया, ये टिक हो गया, ये टिक हो गया. नाउ दिस वन 8 9 12 14 2 4 and 9 11 13 15 with 2 4, these are again the same set of mean terms, so that will again be converted to an octet. Clear? So ye pure aapke ek hi octet ke part hai jisko humne alag alag quad mein banaya tha, to wo aapka ek octet mein convert ho raha hai. Clear? Now here we are left with this, to ye aapka bach raha hai jo aapka kisi ऑक्टेट फॉर्मेशन में नहीं होगा. सो दिस विल बी 6 7 14 15 एंड दिस इज अ क्वाड. हियर आई एम हैविंग वन ऑक्टेट एंड वन क्वाड. ऑक्टेट ये है जिसका 1 डैश डैश डैश. इसका टर्म क्या होगा? पी क्या होगा? व्हाट विल बी द टर्म ऑफ पी? 1 विथ ट्रिपल डैश. 1 डैश 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 क्या होगा? Yes. How do we write the term of P, an octet? It will have only one variable. Sirf ek hi variable hoga. And what is it? Yes, it is just A. That's it. Sirf A. A, B bar, C bar, D bar. Nahi. Kyun hoga bar? These are just crossed. Will not be having anything here. Just A. There will not be any bar. Agar bar hota, bar kab aayega? Jab yahan par zero hoga. Clear? But we are not having anything. It's just a dash. So that will be crossed. Ye cross ho jayega. So it will just be A. Now what about Q? Q kya hoga? 6, 7, 14, 15. And dash position is 1 and 8. तो क्या लिखेंगे इसको? Q को? How will we write Q? 1 and 8. This is dash and this is dash. Then the minimum mean term value is 6. What is say the binary of 6? It is 0, 1, 1, 0. Clear? It's 0, 1, 1, 0. तो क्या हो जाएगा? Dash 1, 1, dash. अब इसका टर्म क्या होगा? What would be the term of Q? Q का टर्म क्या होगा? Yes. What is the term of Q? Yes. Correct. It's B, C. Since both are 1 and 1, it will be B, C. That's it. These positions are crossed. Clear? So here we'll be having A plus BC. अब इसका प्राइम इम्प्लिकेंट चार्ट से हम लोग इसको क्लियर करेंगे. नाउ कमिंग टू द प्राइम इम्प्लिकेंट चार्ट, दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू नो. सिंस वी आर हैविंग डोंट केयर हियर, इन द प्राइम इम्प्लिकेंट चार्ट वी डोंट कंसिडर दी डोंट केयर मीन टर्म्स हम नहीं कंसिडर करते, हम सिर्फ जो आपके एक्चुअल मीन टर्म्स है सिर्फ उन्हीं को कंसिडर करते हैं. सिंस वी हैविंग 6, 7, 8 and 9 एज अवर मीन टर्म्स प्रेजेंट इन द फंक्शन, सो विल जस्ट मेंशन 6, 7, 8, 9. हम प्रीवियस क्वेश्चन में यहाँ पर हमने सारे मीन टर्म्स को लिया था. वी हैड कंसिडर्ड ऑल द मीन टर्म्स. सिंस वी वर नॉट हैविंग एनी डोंट केयर टर्म्स हियर, तो हमने सारे मीन टर्म्स को लिया था. बट इन दिस क्वेश्चन हियर वी आर हैविंग मीन टर्म्स एंड द डोंट केयर टर्म्स ऑल्सो. बट इन द प्राइम इम्प्लिकेंट चार्ट ये पॉइंट हमेशा याद रखना कि डोंट केयर मीन टर्म्स आर नॉट कंसिडर्ड बिकॉज दे आर डोंट केयर्स. तो उनको हमें कंसिडर करना जरूरी नहीं है. इफ इट इज कमिंग अंडर एनी ऑफ द प्राइम इम्प्लिकेंट देन इट इज ओके, इफ इट्स नॉट कमिंग देन ऑल्सो इट्स ओके. वी डोंट एक्चुअली नीड देम, वी नीड देम फॉर अवर रिडक्शन पर्पज. क्लियर? सो हियर इन द प्राइम इम्प्लिकेंट चार्ट विल जस्ट स्टे द मीन टर्म्स विच आर प्रेजेंट इन द फंक्शन, दैट इज 6, 7, 8 and 9. सो विल चेक विद द ऑक्टेट वेदर वट आर द मीन टर्म्स दैट आर गेटिंग कवर्ड. सो हियर ओनली 8 and 9 इज गेटिंग कवर्ड. 8 and 9 हियर एज द मीन टर्म. देन द क्वाड 6, 7, 14, 15. दिस इज 6 एंड दिस इज 7. सो हियर वी हैव 4 मीन टर्म्स एंड वी नीड टू हैव बोथ पी एंड क्यू. सिंस बोथ पी एंड क्यू आर, क्या है पी एंड क्यू? आर द एसेंशियल प्राइम इम्प्लिकेंट्स. तो एसेंशियल प्राइम इम्प्लिकेंट्स है बोथ पी एंड क्यू आर एसेंशियल प्राइम इम्प्लिकेंट्स. सो द मिनिमल एक्सप्रेशन इज ए प्लस बी सी. इज द कंसेप्ट क्लियर स्टूडेंट्स? कंसेप्ट क्लियर है कि नहीं? कंसेप्ट शुड बी वेरी मच क्लियर अबाउट द डोंट केयर ऑल्सो. अगर डोंट केयर है तो एज इट इज पूरा प्रोसेस रहेगा. देर विल नॉट बी एनी चेंज इन एनी ऑफ द प्रोसेस. द प्रोसेस विल बी एज इट इज बट ओनली इन द प्राइम इम्प्लिकेंट चार्ट विल नॉट कंसिडर डोंट केयर टर्म्स. डोंट केयर टर्म्स विल नॉट बी कंसिडर्ड इन द प्राइम इम्प्लिकेंट चार्ट. दैट्स इट. यहाँ पर हम पूरा लेंगे. Here we'll take everything. यहाँ पर don't care terms को भी include करेंगे while pair or quad formation. But here in the prime implicant chart we'll not consider don't care terms and we'll check for EPI. हम EPI के लिए check करेंगे जो भी हमारे quad और octet और pairs हैं उनको हम check करेंगे. Clear? So is the concept of tabular method is clear everyone? Clear? Just reply fast. We are done with this topic. I'll be sending today. आज मैं भेज दूंगी आपको पूरे set of questions है जो आप practice करोगे. ठीक है? So just go on. Now there is one more question. Just look into it. ये बहुत छोटा सा question है, but this is of POS. POS में आपको expression कैसे लिखना है? ये important है. And rest is as it is. POS अगर दिया है. If the function is in POS form, pim dot d, दोनों है आपका. तो indexing as it is करना है. 2 will check with 2. 2 is what? It will come under index 1. 2 में भी हम number of 1s ही check करेंगे. Here हम number of zeros check नहीं करेंगे. 2 क्या होता है? 0, 0, 1, 0. Clear? 8 is 1, 0, 0, 0. So since these are max term, but still we'll check for number of ones and accordingly hum indexing karenge. Rest the complete process is as it is. Ye jo pura process hai, ye pura as it is rahega, including don't care term also. Hum don't care term ko bhi include karenge. And then we'll form the pairs and then we'll form the quads. Jo jo aapke pairs क्वाड में कन्वर्ट हो रहे हैं उनको हम टिक करते जाएंगे और हम यहाँ पे क्वाड में कन्वर्ट करेंगे. और जो आपका नहीं हो रहा है Like we have this pair, and this pair. These are not getting converted to any of the quad. So that will be left as it is. Clear? So here we are having four prime implicants P, Q, R, and S. जैसे हम कर रहे थे बिल्कुल वैसे ही करना है. इंडेक्सिंग में नंबर ऑफ वन से चेक करना है. हमें यहाँ पर मैक्स टर्म्स है तो ऐसा कंफ्यूजन नहीं रहना चाहिए कि हमें जीरोस चेक करना है. हियर आल्सो विल चेक विद द नंबर ऑफ वंस व्हाइल इंडेक्सिंग एंड देन फॉर्मिंग पेयर्स एंड क्वाड्स. सो हियर वी हैव गॉट पी क्यू आर एंड एस. नाउ विल चेक फॉर एसेंशियल प्राइम इम्प्लिकेंस. दैट इज डेफिनेटली विल चेक फॉर द प्राइम इम्प्लिकेंट्स जो जिसमें आपका सिर्फ एक ऐसा मैक्स टर्म हो. हियर इट इज रिटन मीन टर्म बट इट विल बी अ मैक्स टर्म. क्लियर? तो ये वेरी करेगा डिपेंडिंग ऑन द टाइप ऑफ फंक्शन. तो पी आईज द प्राइम इम्प्लिकेंट्स विच इज हैविंग दीज मेनी मैक्स टर्म्स. सो पी इज हैविंग 8, 10, 12, 14. सो सिंस 10 एंड 14 I don't care. So here it is not mentioned. Only we are mentioning 2, 3, 8, 12, 13. 2, 3, 8, 12, 13. So 8, then 12. Q is what? It's a pair. So 12, 13. 12, 13. R is 2, 10. 2. 10 is don't care. That will not be considered. S is what? It's 2, 3. 2, 3. तो यहाँ पर वी कैन सी कि विच वन इज ईपीआई. यहाँ पर दिस इज एन ईपीआई बिकॉज इट इज हैविंग 8 इन इट. क्यू इज ऑल्सो एन ईपीआई बिकॉज इट इज हैविंग 13 इन इट. आर इज नॉट एन ईपीआई बिकॉज इट इज हैविंग 2 एंड 10. सिंस 10 इज डोंट केयर दैट इज नॉट मेंशन्ड एंड 2 इज नॉट अ सिंगल टर्म. It is shared by other prime implicant. S 2, 3. 3 is not getting shared. So it will have P, Q, and S. These are the prime implicants, essential prime implicants. So we need to write the terms of it. That is important. Now, how to write P? P kya hai? It's 8, 10, 12, 14 with the dash position at 2 and 4. So what is 2? If I have to write A, B, C, D. Dash position is 2. This is the dash and this one is dash. Okay. Now what is the minimum max term? 8. How do we write 8? 8 is 1, 0, 0, 0. But since These are the max terms. हमें इसको max term form में लिखना है ठीक है. तो max term form that means you'll have to write this A. This is 8 is 1 0 0 0. This is 1 and this is 0. But max term है तो A 1 होगा तो it will be A bar and D is 0 it will be D and it will be of the form A bar plus D. This is how it is written. 8 is 1000. So, ye to aapka BC to cross hai. So, it will be A bar. D is 0. So, it will be directly taken. A bar plus D. It is a sum term. It's not a product term. It is a sum term. A bar plus D. Clear? This is how it is written. Now coming to Q. Q agar rahega, to it is 12, 13 with the position dash position at 1. So how do we write 12, 13 hai to? 12, 13 dash position at 1. This is the dash position. Theek hai? Now what is 12? How do we write 12? 12 is 1, 1, 0, 0. So it will be the minimum min term is 12. So it is 1, 1, 0. What would be the term of it? That is A bar plus B bar plus C. This one. A bar plus B bar plus C. Is it becoming clear, students? हमें इसका टर्म कैसे लिखना है, दैट इज इम्पॉर्टेंट. आपका ये POS में दिया है, तो POS is a type of, the way we write the term is different in the case of POS. Here we write the sum term. Here we are not writing the product term. Here we are writing the sum term. Clear? So this is how we are writing. Now the next one is S. S को कैसे लिखेंगे? How will we write S? Dash position is 1. So this is the dash position. D is the dash position. Then the minimum value of min term is 2. It is 0010. So it will be 0, 0, 1 and dash. Clear? So what will be the term of it? A plus B plus C bar. This one. A plus B plus C bar.